Welcome to
have Mr. Tom Tognoli on, the CEO and founder of Intero Real Estate Services. How you doing, Tom?
Doing outstanding, Mike. Happy to be here.
Of course. Thanks for coming on.
You bet.
And we got a lot to get to today, and it's going to be a fun time. But just a reminder for those of you just tuning in, there's always a couple different ways you can listen to the show. That is on the radio at KDOW 1220 AM, or you can go online to KDOW.biz or RERadioLive.com, and you can click the Listen Now button. Or you can download our apps. You can download the KDOW app or the iHeartRadio app. And also, we are on iTunes now, so you can go on iTunes and download our podcasts. We are podcasting every show. And we are having a good time. So we're on iTunes, working on getting on the Android market next. So everything is going great for Real Estate Radio Live, and you can listen to us on the podcast now. But if you don't want to do that, we come to you 5 days a week live, Monday through Friday from 3 to 4 p.m. with bonus coverage on Wednesdays and Fridays from 2 to 3. And also, we are a live show, so we love to get your questions and your phone calls on the air, and you can give us a call at 1-800-516-1220. That's 1-800-516-1220. Or if you're bashful, you can go online and submit your question there. You can go to MikeSellsSiliconValley.com and you can click the Contact Me tab and submit your question while we're on the air. And that's been happening a lot lately, whether we're on the air or off the air. We've been getting some emails here and there, and that's what a lot of our shows are based on. It's whatever content that you desire, and we want to appeal to you guys. So definitely reach out, whether it's online or give us a call. And tomorrow, just a quick plug, tomorrow is the last live event of the year. That's the Financial Foundation. That's Five Building Blocks for Life. And that's the live show at the Toll House Hotel in Los Gatos. And that's from 3 to 4, the radio program. And then from 4 to 6 is networking and drinks and apps. So can't go wrong with some drinking and eating, I guess, right? So anyways, that's tomorrow. November 3rd. God, I can't believe it's already November. It's crazy. So, all right, well, let's get into it, Tom. We got a lot to get to. And, you know, I'm going to ask you about a recent speech that you gave at a marketing meeting that a lot of realtors and different industry people go to. And it's going to kind of roll into the Intero history as well. So we often talk about the history of Intero. So this was at a, you know, every week, a lot of people that listen to the show might not know there's tours. There's the, you know, tour for Silvar, tour for Score, and it's where a lot of the, you know, realtors meet up to talk about properties that are coming on in the market. They put their property on tour, and, you know, they basically pitch their listings, right?
Right.
And so at this, though, is more of a business building exercise, and really the topic was having leaders of the industry there, which obviously you're one of them. You're CEO of one of the best companies around.
Mm-hmm.
And so let's talk about that a little bit, because I think it's relevant for a lot of the listeners, because we do have a lot of business owners that listen. So it's not only just because you're in the real estate industry, but I think it relates to a lot of people in business. So let's get started on that, I guess.
Yeah. So, you know, it was a couple of weeks ago, and I got asked to go speak at this marketing meeting. And I think it was called Captains of the Industry, and they're having different CEOs from different real estate companies come in and talk. And so I just shared with people, really, you know, I've been in this business for 30 years.
Yeah.
Just gave a little bit of my story in the real estate business and the things that I've seen in my 30 years of being in this business that have made people successful and the things that have made people not so successful. And I think it doesn't necessarily just apply to real estate. It applies to really any business, you know. And, I mean, there are all these different areas of things like time management and other things like that you really ultimately need to do to be successful. And I think what, you know, kind of got you interested or you were talking about before is this is a little bit of my story, you know, and my passion about, you know, why it is that I do what I do every day. You know, I've certainly been blessed. I was born here in Silicon Valley, raised here in Silicon Valley, and, you know, have been blessed to be relatively successful.
Right.
In the real estate industry.
But it hasn't always been easy,
right,
though.
And I mean,
you've been through a lot of ups and downs.
Right, and I think that's what happens a lot of times. People see, you know, or see your title or see you there, and they just think that, you know, it's always been easy. And it hasn't always been easy,
right,
you know, for me. And I shared the story that, you know, I was I was a special ed kid going through school, undiagnosed ADHD.
Yeah.
You know, my early years in the real estate business, and back then, so I'm going to be 52 in January.
Mm-hmm.
And so if you go back to when, I was in elementary school, they didn't have such a thing as ADHD and dyslexia. It didn't exist. You were just hyper and stupid.
Yeah.
And so I was kind of the hyper stupid kid,
you said it, not me.
I said it, at least that was the, now, fortunately for me, I was always a good kid,
Yeah.
I was always very respectful of my elders and just a good person. So, my personality, I think, and, my outgoing personality and just kind of always had an entrepreneurial spirit about me, which,
mm-hmm.
Actually, now that I've gotten older, if you start to do research on people that are ADHD and dyslexic,
yeah.
There's actually an awesome, awesome book. Actually, there's a great author. His name is Malcolm Gladwell. He's written a lot of great books. He wrote one called Outliers, and he wrote another one called David and Goliath, which is actually – that's his most recent book, David and Goliath, and I really, really liked it. It talks about – when you go back and you look at a lot of great leaders in Silicon Valley, and really just in business in general, not just Silicon Valley, but business in general, a lot of them had learning disabilities, and how sometimes having a learning disability, can actually be a benefit, because what ultimately ends up happening is, in order to compensate for things like I couldn't read very well, as my mom used to call them, the wiggles in class, right? They never would sit still, right? But what you ultimately end up doing is right? And so you ultimately end up compensating in other areas, right?
Yeah.
So maybe I didn't excel in kind of the academic part of school so much, but I certainly learned to excel in personal relationships with people,
right.
and how to, quite candidly rally people around me that kind of, it would help to compensate for my, the things that I wasn't so good at,
right.
And then how later in life it just, all of that stuff ultimately ended up helping me to, become the person I am, again, getting in the real estate business, wasn't easy. I tell people I'm an SOB.
Yeah.
Son of a broker.
Right.
Yeah. I said that in there. My mom was a realtor. And so on the surface, a lot of people think, what a great thing. Your mom was in the real estate business. And I was fresh out of college at 23. But the problem was, my mom, all of our friends and family were my mom's clients.
Right.
All of my friends couldn't afford to buy houses. All of my friends' parents thought I was a little kid. And at 51 today, I think I look like I'm probably maybe 40. But when you're 23 and you look like 16 and you're trying to sell somebody's single largest asset, it was incredibly challenging. And so, I had to scrap and claw and scream early on in this business, which I think built a great foundation for me to be successful later on in life.
Yeah, and also, too, you mentioned, relationship building.
Yep.
And you grew, and that's basically what real estate is. Yeah, we do transactions and we help people on servicer listings or buyers and that type of thing. But really, at the end of the day, it's about lead generation and relationship management, basically.
It is.
And that's how you grow a good business. And not even in real estate. And a lot of the business owners that listen to the show, it's the same thing. So I think that's why it's good to hear about that.
And I think, especially when you have entrepreneurs, I think what ends up happening is, all of the money in almost any business, not just real estate, not just mortgage, not just title, it doesn't matter what widget you're selling. All the money is typically made in doing the activities you don't want to do.
Right. Yeah.
And it's the reason why 20% of the people make 80% of the money, because only 20% of the people are willing to do the activities that you don't want to do in order to be successful.
Right.
Part of my message there was force yourself to do those activities you don't want to do, and don't spend all your time trying to figure out how can I not do those activities that I need to do and still make the kind of money that somebody's who's willing to do, because you never will figure it out.
Yeah.
And I think, where we live in technology and innovation, which is great, sometimes gives people this this idea that, and look at the internet's great, and people in our business leverage things like Zillow and Trulia and Realtor.com and all of those help generate leads and business, but at the end of the day, it's ultimately, focusing on doing the activity, and so it doesn't matter. Yeah, it doesn't matter what you do.
Yeah,
all the dough is made in doing the activities you don't want to do.
Right. No, that's great advice. And going back to your path into Intero really quick, mm-hmm. to fast forward. And we just got a couple minutes left. And if you have any questions for Tom, by the way, 1-800-516-1220 is the number. He's a wealth of knowledge on anything real estate related or business building too. Just don't be afraid to give us a call. But let's go. So you're at Century 21 for how many years?
Well, so I got started in the business, you know, young kid, 23, only like 18 months. And yeah. I went to work at Contempo Realty in 1989, which is where I created the relationships with all of the people that we really started at Intero with.
Yeah.
You know, ultimately. And we started Intero in 2002. You know, we had an angel investor when we started the company, mm-hmm. which was great. And it was part of the reason why we were able to grow the company so fast. Certainly, I think a lot of it was also, you know, the culture, the values, the vision of our company.
And isn't Intero one of the fastest, you call it, organically grown companies?
Yeah, so, you know, we were one of the, we were recognized as one of the fastest growing real estate companies in the country.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and most companies, you know, if any company grows as quickly as we did in our industry, you typically are doing it through acquisitions where you're acquiring other companies and buying companies
exactly,
and merging them in with you. And we didn't do that. You know, we went from, you know, zero to over 1,000 people. I can't even remember, you know, probably 24 months,
mm-hmm.
you know, and we did that just recruiting one person at a time. That
right.
just kind of, you know, came on board because they believed in what we were doing and, you know, really ultimately, you know, that was what really led to our growth. And that was kind of the unique story, is it wasn't
yeah.
like we went out and bought companies that ended up resulting in us have 1,000 people. We, you know, we got 1,000 people one person at a time.
Yeah, absolutely.
Which isn't the easiest way to do it.
Yeah.
You know, I often tell people, you know, building a company, you know, most people only have one of them in you.
Yeah.
You only have one in you.
Yeah.
You know, maybe some people have two, but especially in our business, because our widget in the real estate business is people.
Yeah.
You know, we don't have a... You know, we don't have an iPhone or, you know, Android or something like that, right?
Right.
It's you know, our assets, people. And so to recruit one person at a time and get people to believe in your cause and rally for it is, you know, is a lot of hard work.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know?
And then the company went, like most real estate companies in 2007, 8, 9, went through some rough times, right? And so did you. And
yep.
then now look at where we are today, you know, bought by Berkshire Hathaway. So
yep.
take us through that. We just got like a minute left and we'll probably have to finish it up.
Yeah, no worries. Yeah. So, you know, we started the company with an angel investor in 2002, and you can cut me off whenever
yeah.
we need to kind of go on
yeah.
a break. But, and then in, you know, we, myself and you know, two of my, the former founders and another one of the guys who was working with us, Bob Moles, there was me and John Thompson,
yeah.
Bob Moles and Gino Blafari. We wanted to buy the angel investor out for a couple of years, and they just weren't interested in selling us their interest in the company. And finally, in April of 2007, we were able to persuade them to sell us the entire company. And
yeah.
so the four of us, you know, basically, you know, shook our piggy banks out, refinanced our houses, went out and got a massive line of credit, a business loan, basically, to acquire the company. And I think everybody knows what happened after 2007.
Yeah, we'll talk about that on the other side because that's where things get interesting. So if you have any questions for myself, for Tom Tognoli, 1-800-516-1220 is the number. Tom Tognoli, the CEO and founder of Intero Real Estate, is on today. Happy to have him on. I'm Mike D'Ambrosio. This is Real Estate Radio Live. Stick around. We'll be right back.
For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com.
Welcome back. This is Mike D'Ambrosio on Real Estate Radio Live, KDOW 1220 AM. Happy to have Mr. Tom Tognoli in studio today, CEO of Intero Real Estate Services. And we'd love to hear from you guys. If you have any questions, 1-800-516-1220. And this segment's brought to you by Giorgio's Italian Food and Pizzeria and Frankie Giant Luigi's 2, the best Italian food around with four convenient locations throughout the Bay Area to serve you. So you can go to Giorgio's and FJLItalian.com for more info on their famous happy hour specials. And isn't that right? Weren't you just there last night?
Oh, man, the best sausage pizza I've
go.
Ever had for Frankie Giant Luigi 2 last. Although my waist didn't appreciate it
yeah.
too much this morning.
There you go. A special endorsement from Mr. Tom Tognoli. I love it. All right. So let's get back into the story because it's a really interesting story about how Intero came, you know, to where
yep.
it is today. And so you guys bought the company from the original
investors
yeah, in 2007.
Right, in April of 2007. And so, as I mentioned before the break, I think everybody you know, knows what happened in 2007,
yeah.
you know, the Great Recession, the financial meltdown, and all of that. And so... you know, and I often tell people it wasn't like, you know, none of – there was four of us. It was me and Gino Blafari, John Thompson, and Bob Moles. And it's not like we were Silver Spoon kids that, you know, inherited a bunch of money, and you know, like literally, I mean, we were just local guys that were kind of, you know, scrapping and clawing real estate people, right? And so we ponied up everything that we had. You had to personally guarantee. I mean, you remember, we have a big company at the time, you know, thousands of realtors and franchise companies, and so you know, we had to get many millions of dollars in a loan from a bank. And then you know, right after we acquired the company, probably like the next month or two is like really when things got started to get really bad. And we were literally burning through, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars a month negative, you know. And so I can remember our CFO coming to us every month, you know, hey, I need another, you know, 500 grand, I need another 500 grand, another 500 grand. And we were like, oh my God, you know, and and to the point where, you know, myself and, you know, one of the other partners, I mean, literally refinanced my parents' house, you know, to make payroll. And I mean, it wasn't, it was like, you know, late 2008, you know, and it was like, I just, you know, it was unbearable. You know, I mean, I tell everybody I could count every single spot on the ceiling in my bedroom because you couldn't sleep at night. You know, it was just so, you know, so crazy, you know. But the funny thing is when you go through an experience like that and your back is against the wall, because what people don't understand is, you know, people might say, why didn't you just throw in the towel? You know, well, number one, it wasn't just in our nature to throw in the towel anyway. Right. But also, when you have a personally guaranteed line of credit or personally guaranteed loan with a bank, you know, they can take all your assets from you, whatever assets we had left, which wasn't a lot at the time. But it was, you know, and so, you know, we scrapped and clawed, and then we kind of started coming out of the recession finally. There was like, you know, the sun broke through the clouds, and it was like, oh my God, we're, you know, we're maybe going to make this thing.
Yeah.
And as we came out of the recession, you know, because we just busted our butts so hard during the recession just to do whatever it took to be successful, while a lot of other companies were kind of just consolidating and downsizing and getting smaller in every business, including the real estate business, we just were out there recruiting and hiring more and more realtors. And, you know, and a lot of real estate agents were looking for leadership, you know, and we're looking for, you know, because, you know, obviously we were scared, although the agents never knew that. I don't even know that I was scared. It was like, you know, we were just working our butts off. But real estate agents and people were looking for leadership, and they were looking for, you know, hope and guidance. Yeah. And so
it was a tough time. I came into the business in 2008.
Yeah.
You know, and it was scary. It was hard. And I started in Sacramento, which was like the worst market to get into real estate to. But I feel like it helped me in the long run because I didn't start in 2004, 2005 when things were crazy, you know.
Yeah.
I think if you go through that time, it makes you a better person, or better, you know, made me a better realtor, I guess.
Right. So we came out of it in, you know, in 2009, you know, it's like, oh my God, things are getting better. And so we actually came out of the recession better than we went into the recession, you know, and so that which does not kill you makes you stronger. You hear that all the time. And the reality of it is it's true, you know, you know, we ended up coming out better, stronger, you know, leaner, tougher than we did going into it. And, you know, we came out of the market just on fire, which was great. And then things were going, you know, fantastic. And, you know, we had no interest in selling the company. We were finally making money. And, you know, as I tell people, it takes a lot longer to fill in the hole than it does to dig the hole. So,
right.
You know, so we were still in the process of filling in the hole that the recession had created. And we were approached by, you know, Home Services, which is part of the Berkshire Hathaway family of companies. And a gentleman by the name of Ron Peltier, and, you know, said, hey, you know, we're looking for good, you know, quality brand company, and we want to be in California. Are you guys interested? And initially we're like, you know, not really, but, you know, when Warren Buffett and Berkshire Hathaway come knocking, you listen, right?
Yeah,
you know,
absolutely.
And so, you know, again, it wasn't our intention, but we knew that it was like, this was like a once in a lifetime opportunity. You know, we'd built a great thing, and, you know, to be affiliated with Berkshire Hathaway, have the financial resources, really unlimited financial resources, have the name and integrity of Berkshire Hathaway behind us, and the culture that we've built at Intero, based in the Bay Area and Silicon Valley, you know, we just felt like it was a marriage that we just couldn't pass up, and it was going to be a great thing, and obviously it's been a great thing since, and, you know, we're just, we're about a year and a half into being Intero Real Estate Services.
And they still let you run the company as you know, you did before, basically.
Yeah, it's awesome. If you do any research on Warren Buffett and Berkshire Hathaway, that's how they do it. They buy premium companies and they let you run and operate them the way you want, which was the other appeal to us. We didn't, you know, certainly, you know, you've got to be successful, and if you're doing your job and doing well, they just leave you alone. And and let you do what you're good at doing, which has been fantastic.
Awesome. All right. Well, we got to take a quick break. 1-800-516-1220 is the number. Tom Tognoli, the CEO of Intero Real Estate Services, is on today. 1-800-516-1220 is the number.
RadioLive.com. Again, your host for today's edition of Real Estate Radio Live, Mike D'Ambrosio.
Welcome back. This is Mike D'Ambrosio on Real Estate Radio Live, KDOW 1220 AM. We have Tom Tognoli, the CEO of Intero Real Estate Services, live in studio today. And if you have any questions for Tom or for myself, 1-800-516-1220. And this segment's brought to you by Taps Termite, serving the Bay Area for over 45 years. Taps Termite is committed to keeping your living area pest-free by using the newest and safest technology. You can call them today at 408-259-5900. So let's finish up really quick on the whole Intero story. I know you had one more thing you wanted to talk about, and then we'll get into the market and some other things we wanted to talk about today.
Yeah, cool. So, I'd said that, I had to borrow money from my parents, and
yeah.
I'll never forget, when we finally sold the company, and we sold the company in May of last year, so May of 2014. Mm-hmm. I wish I could have gone, but for whatever reason, I didn't. My wife went with my dad. They had to go down to First Republic Bank to pay their $750,000 loan off on their house that we had taken out. And, my dad's, I think my dad just turned 83, so he was 82. And my wife walks in, and they go up, to the banker, and they pay him. And as my wife gives my dad a hug and thanks him. And my parents are super cool. Mm-hmm. And my dad walks out and looks at my wife and goes, I never doubted him. I knew he was going to do it. And Lynn just looked at him inside. She was like, oh, if he only knew.
My
81-year-old dad just had no idea. And the reality of it is, they did know is I'm like completely transparent with my parents. They knew.
Yeah.
I mean, I had told my parents, look, if it goes much longer, I'm moving in. You got a room for me? Start clearing it out, But it was crazy.
Yeah.
But all good.
It's a great story. And Intero's doing really well right now. And,
awesome. Yeah.
So any updates on Intero that you want to?
No, I mean, it's things are going great. Being part of, Berkshire Hathaway and Home Services is awesome. Home Services is continuing to acquire companies. I had mentioned to you before we got on the radio today, just acquired another big company out in Wisconsin. I can't even remember the name of it. They just acquired that company about 2 months ago. Again, about the size of Intero, but again, because they're in Wisconsin and we're in California,
right?
They actually do more business than we do, more units, but probably only sell about a quarter of the real estate that we sell because our prices are so
right.
high here in California.
And we always talk, I always talk about it on the show about, we just live in such the mecca of real estate and across the whole country and even in the world.
Yep.
And I think a lot of people take that for granted sometimes,
They do.
So it's good to sit back and reflect and realize that we are very lucky to be living in the Silicon Valley,
uh-huh.
both as property owners and in our business selling real estate. I think it's a good place to be. So it's funny that, a company like that worth, because of the amount of volume they do, just about a quarter of what we're doing. And so it's all relative, basically. Any other updates on, the market that you've seen countywide with we have, 14 corporate offices. So
yep.
Anything you hear
know,
a lot of different things.
You know, I think that, I say this, and I probably said this on this radio show before, is it's interesting and probably not super surprising, but, the Bay Area housing market does really – in many ways walk in lockstep with the S&P 500.
Yeah.
And so, over the last several months, stock market's been super turbulent. We're down 10% or
mm-hmm.
more, and now we're back up. I think today we may have almost touched, an all-time high on the Dow again.
Yeah.
Coming out of Labor Day, the market seemed to slow down a bit. And again, I'm not sure how much of that was just seasonality, time of the year. Probably a combination of that combined with, kind of the pullback of the stock market. Things kind of seemed like took a little bit of a breather.
Yeah, it did.
Yeah, but I get a sense just from what I'm seeing right now, there's just still nothing for sale.
Yeah.
I mean, the market's just so dry, especially in the heart of Silicon Valley.
Well,
I was in Los Gatos, Saratoga marketing meeting last week that I spoke at. I saw they had the tour sheet come out, and there were like two houses on the tour sheet in Los Gatos and four houses in Saratoga.
Yeah.
I mean, normal is, you know, 15.
Right.
You know, and so it's kind of crazy.
Well, now, on the other side of the break, I want to talk about where I think the inventory is going to go over the next couple of months, but we'll get into a little bit more of the market and the holidays and Intero Foundation, too, I want to talk about
as well.
So 1-800-516-1220 is the number. Tom Tognoli is on today. I'm Mike D'Ambrosio. He's had the pleasure of having Mr. Tom Tognoli in studio today, the CEO and one of the founders of Intero Real Estate Services. And if you have any questions, it's your last chance, 1-800-516-1220. And we're going to talk a little bit more about the market. And before we do that, this segment is brought to you by Starburst Construction, and they have been serving the Silicon Valley for over 40 years. So you can visit them today at starburstconstruction.com. That's Starburst like the candy. Or you can check out all of our vendors and our partners here on the radio on my website at MikeSellsSiliconValley.com. So we were talking about the market a little bit, Tom, before we went on break, and I see it. I mean, right now we're hovering in between 1,400 and 1,500 some odd units in Santa Clara County. And a lot of times when I talk inventory on the show, I use Santa Clara County. We have listeners all in multiple counties.
Right.
But, you know, Santa Clara County is the heart of Silicon Valley, so we often look at that. And I see it going down to, again, like it did last year, beginning of this year, 800-900 units, in the new year. And that's going to create this – I see it might maybe creating another frenzy again, or a little bit of a frenzy in the beginning of the year, and then having it level out as the year goes on. What do you think about that?
Yeah, I mean, nobody has a crystal ball.
Right.
You know, I think, intuitively, I'm going to say that I think as long as the stock market stays relatively healthy, not that it needs to go up another 1,000 points, but it just doesn't drop significantly.
Yeah.
You know, I do think there, you know, if the Fed raises rates in December, whether it really has an immediate impact on mortgage rates or not, I think that could fuel some more buyers. So I think that, you know, I think that you're right. I think that, you know, as inventory, I mean, buyers, you know, a lot of times sellers think that buyers are just going to be most active, you know, in March and in the summer. And certainly, you know, the weather helps, but the reality of it is serious buyers are in the market all the time.
Yeah.
January, February, March, April, all the way through December.
Right.
And so, you know, when you're a home seller and you have, you know, less than 1,000 houses on the market in Santa Clara County, you know, which is probably going to happen, you know, later this month, December, January timeframe, you know, it's not like the buyers all of a sudden, you know, stopped wanting to buy.
Right.
They still want to buy the ones at least that you want to buy your home, right? You don't want the looky-loo. Yeah, you know, you don't want the one that's not really motivated. I mean, the one who's going to pay you top dollar as a seller for your home is the motivated buyers. And they're going to be in the market, you know, throughout the holidays still. And so, you know, I agree with you. I think, you know, my personal opinion about just the market in general is that, you know, I don't see property values appreciating at the same rate in 2016 as they did in 2015, as I didn't see them. But I still, you know, personally believe based on just everything I read and watch and listen to, et cetera, that, you know, our market's still, you know, got some good legs in it. And as crazy as it sounds, I think with low interest rates, low inventory, and I don't see that changing anytime soon, I think our market's going to, you know.
Well, it's going to always be. I think it's going to be like, not always, but for a long time, because there's just simply we can't keep up with the demand as far as from a building perspective.
Right.
You know, as far as new units are concerned, we can't keep up with that. You know, there's a lack of land. We're getting more and more jobs here.
I mean, I don't know if you saw. I mean, I think I just put that email out to the company last week.
I talked about it on the show on Friday.
Oh, did you? Apple just acquired more land. Yeah. And so, you know, I mean, who knows what they're going to do with it? I mean, there's speculation that they're going to start building cars.
Right.
You know, who knows? I mean, nobody knows. But at the end of the day, you know, when you have companies like them acquiring land, you know, I mean, ultimately, you've got to think that, you know, there's going to be ups and downs. We're going to go in a recession at some point.
Yeah.
It's just inevitably going to happen. But for the long haul, I mean, I think the Silicon Valley and Bay Area is, you know, we're in the sweet spot, you know, really of the real estate market, you know, not just for California, but for the country. And in many cases, I would argue just around the world because of the stability of our economy and everything else.
Yeah. Well, then the question becomes, where does that spill over into surrounding us?
Mm-hmm.
What other areas? And that's, again, no one has a crystal ball. But I mean, one of the areas I see is South County.
I agree.
Or even the Central Valley, too. over time?
I mean, I think the challenge, you know, I love the East Bay. You know, I think still one of the biggest challenges that they haven't quite been able to get figured out yet is transportation into the jobs. And, you know, and you see, you know, and it's just gotten bad. I mean,
traffic's miserable.
It is miserable. I mean, you know, even coming in from Gilroy and Morgan Hill and Hollister, although I'm hearing people go out there, you know, other areas, you know, that I think, you know, all have some good appeal to them, to me at least. Where the commute and the prices aren't as much as they are here, and the commute's probably not as bad as those, is like over on the other side of 17.
Yeah.
Up in Scotts Valley, Santa Cruz, Capitola, Aptos. I mean, it's still a ways away from work, but when you compare it to driving 2 hours in from Tracy.
Right.
Or, you know, I had a breakfast with somebody on Friday from Gilroy. It takes him, you know, he said an hour and a half to drive into Mountain View each way every day.
Yeah.
You know, and so I think you can drive in from, you know, Aptos, you know, a lot less time than that.
Yeah, and you'll be near the beach, right?
So amen.
The whole motto for both South County and for Santa Cruz is drive a little, save a lot, I guess.
Oh, really? I like it.
That's what they say.
Nice.
Laura's sitting over here. She thinks I'm corny. I didn't make it up. Come on. But no, I agree with you. I think those, you know, you can definitely, if you, especially with the people that can telecommute or they can work from home, it makes sense for some people.
It does. I mean, like I said, it's just, I mean, the super far out areas. Unless they're going to be able to figure out mass transit, which they'll figure out eventually.
They will. It might be too late, though. We'll see. Anyways, we got to take a quick break. We're going to wrap the show up on the other side. Tom Tognoli's in, the CEO of Intero Real Estate Services, and I'm Mike D'Ambrosio. You've been listening to Real Estate Radio.
It's RERadioLive.com. Tune in, log in, download our podcast.